Hi guys, so we're gonna get right into the video today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate all the support and stuff like that. If you haven't already, please subscribe. I do have a Patreon that you guys can support me there, and as well as liking on and following on Instagram. Thank you guys so much for your support, and let's get right into the video. So with that being said, the first thing I wanna cover is form. A lot of people lack good form when bench pressing. AKA bench pressing should be a whole body type movement to get the most maximum effort out of your bench presses, because you know, when you're stable and you're tight and you're moving, incorporating your whole body, that's when you can get the most out of your bench press. So see how I set up for my form. I know you see a lot of powerlifters and they have like a huge arch in their back. I can understand why. I don't necessarily support your back being all the way at the top of the bar. I feel like there should still be a huge amount of give before then. But one of the things that I want to emphasize is hand placement. Where you place your hands on the bar matters, because that's where you're going to use different muscles to support the movement in total. As you can see, I am adjusting my feet as I adjust my hands. I normally like to bench with my feet pretty much tucked back and keeping my legs tight and arched, and making sure my upper back is digging into the actual bench itself. So it's just a tight, explosive back stabilization. I don't normally bench super flat. Like, I see a lot of people bench super flat, and it feels uncomfortable. So I never really do that at all. When I first benched and stuff like that, I was doing it, but as soon as I got into powerlifting and learned that there's certain, you know, ways to maximize your strength, my coach was able to guide me and teach me different ways. Another thing I want to emphasize is breathing. Your breathing has a lot to do with a lot of workouts, as everyone knows. Your breathing can influence if you even get a lift or not, just from exploding up on that last breath. If you can see in my bench press, I normally have a rhythm to it, and you can see it right there. I exhaled on the explosion and kept my abdomen and my chest tight, kind of like a squat in a way, to keep that tension on my core, you know, to help with that explosive means of power. I see a lot of people kind of critiquing, you know, the way a lot of powerlifters bench press, because once again, they're up like a McDonald's M. And personally, I don't believe in benching like that, but there are some powerlifters that do bench like that, and I don't really think they get the weight, which is why I try to keep myself relatively close to the bench, because it doesn't make sense to be all the way up there. You're not actually lifting the weight like that. Another thing that I see a lot of people struggling with is simply locking out elbows. A lot of people have trouble in that lockout, and I think it's purely due to activating your supporter muscles a lot more than, you know, you normally would. As soon as when I lift, I first thing I think is elbows, to lock out those elbows, because that's the halfway point. And once you get it halfway, you pretty much got it all the way at that point. So for this specific workout, I was doing 5 reps of bench press, and I finished off on a single rep of a certain amount of weight, because I was doing, I think I ended on 235, and I got 235, but I felt like I could go up. I haven't maxed on bench in a long time, and this guy was nice enough to spot me and stuff like that. I did for every one rep was, you know, equivalent to the five that I was going to do. So I did three extra that weren't necessarily in my program. Another thing I like to work on is form explosive bench press. And that's just doing a relatively light or heavy-ish kind of, heavy-ish, lightish kind of weight. Whatever helps you train that explosive, bounce on your, not bounce, but on your chest, that explosiveness, whatever weight helps you move that and, you know, do that. I normally do that at the end, and it really does help train my breathing, my grip, my form. I do that normally just to go over, just a review of my workout pretty much. Normally it's with a way lighter weight. 225 is not super heavy, but it's not light either. So these are just kind of accessory works that my coach put in for me as well. Support working those supporter muscles, which are the biceps, the triceps, shoulders, and upper back. Those things definitely can help you get a bigger bench very easily. And of course, I have my burnout session at the end, which is the biceps, triceps, and the shoulders. And that's pretty much going to be the whole video. If you made it this far, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have any suggestions about any workouts that you guys might want to see, anything that I do, just let me know in the comments. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next one. If you would like to, follow me on Instagram. Link is in the description. Follow me on Patreon if you would like to. That's completely optional. And follow me on YouTube to make sure that you know when I hit a PR. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.